So recognition is a really important part of resilience. If you feel recognised, you feel motivated, and if you feel motivated, you've got a buffer to feeling more resilient. So that's what we're going to look at now. So I want to move now to our last thing, which is recognition. So I'm going to show you a couple of clips from Undercover Boss here. You've all seen Undercover Boss?
Yeah.
No? No? No. Oh, it's just lovely telly. Yeah. Well, I like it anyway. So what happens is a boss, who's generally the CEO of a business, a company or something, is invited to go and spend time on the front line. And they're usually in disguise. So this guy runs a party. They send out all kinds of stuff for parties. So he's on the front line packing stuff. And this guy here works packaging stuff up. So he's just there finding out about her life. So we'll see two clips, and then we'll see the first one will be him just finding out what it's like working on the front line of his business.
Always make sure that it's green before you put your next items down.
Okay.
Okay?
You know, lesson learned on that one.
How long have you been doing this job?
For 3 years now.
What's it like working here?
Communication's a lot, you know, needed.
So you don't think this company does a good job with communication?
I wouldn't say from the higher ups, no.
Oh, you don't get to talk to any of the big wigs?
Well, the CEO sometimes will come in, but that's basically just telling us numbers and stuff.
Julia called me out as a CEO. It's not just enough to have these meetings with all the warehouse employees and to give updates on our business so that communication is not working the way it needs to.
Well, I came up with a suggestion once and never heard back anything on it.
What was the suggestion?
You know, I was telling them that maybe they should start focusing more on the Hispanic community, you know. They have like quinceañeras and stuff like that, which is a birthday. They could sell them a lot of balloons or, you know, like the fake flowers or, you know, tablecloths. They use a lot of that stuff.
You never heard back. At least give some feedback. Okay, well, that makes sense. Oh, it's moving again. You want to work here for a long time, or do you have other dreams?
No.
What's your long-term dream?
Take pictures, do photography.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
How long have you been doing photography?
For a long time now.
How fast do you go on this?
I usually can do like 1,600 items an hour.
You usually get your bonus?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah? Does that help a lot?
It does. I usually get about $200.
That's good. Every little bit counts, right?
Oh, yeah. Especially with my niece.
Oh, what about your niece?
Her mom's not doing too good right now, so I take care of her.
Oh, you do?
Her mom, she's looking at like 5 years in prison.
Oh.
Yeah. It sucks, but...
Yeah.
All right. At least my niece is doing okay, so that's all I'm worried about.
I really admire Julia as a person for what she's done. She's going to be watching her niece for at least probably the next 5 years, and I'm just extremely impressed by her as a person, that she's willing to make that sacrifice.
Okay.
He's
got a wig on and glasses and beard, and he doesn't usually have those. So she just is under the impression that he's a part-time worker come in to make a TV program about what it's like working in that company.
Okay.
So that's what she's thinking. So what do we know about Julia?
She's bright, she cares.
She's bright, she cares.
She's hardworking.
She's hardworking.
She doesn't really want to be in that job. She wants to be a photographer, not a
She wants to be
packer.
A photographer, not a packer.
She's got
a picker. She's got ideas.
She's got social conscience.
She's got a tough home life.
It's a job, not a calling.
It's a job, not a calling. But what's made it that? Because actually, she was displaying some of the behaviours of a calling.
She feels she's not listened to.
Right, she feels she's not listened to. It's the numero uno thing that people just don't feel listened to. Well, they don't feel heard. Right, so someone might listen, but they don't feel heard. There's a difference. So I'm going to show you what happens next. So now you're going to see the CEO having a different kind of conversation. So she's been called in. She doesn't know what's happened. She's been called in to see the CEO. And I'd just like you to think about a real felt emotion in this.
Julia, you said that you submitted an idea and you thought there was a lot of opportunity to provide more product to the Hispanic market.
Mm-hmm.
And you were frustrated because you said you put the idea up and you never heard anything about it.
Mm-mm.
So I'm going to have you work with our product development team and our merchandising team on how we can best expand our Hispanic line of merchandise, and that's a paid position.
Awesome.
Sound good?
Oh, yeah.
You mentioned you have a passion for photography.
Yes.
I want to give you the right equipment.
So I'm serious?
I'm serious. I think you got a lot of talent there, but you need to have the right equipment. So I'm going to give you $5,000 so you can go out and get a really top-notch camera that a real photographer would need so you can start to pursue that passion that you have.
Thank you.
You talked about your niece, raising your niece while your sister's going through some tough times. Mm-hmm. So I want to help you out. So I'm going to give you $30,000.
Oh, my God. Are you serious?
I'm serious. I really want you to be able to give your niece a great start.
Well, thank you so much.
And I really appreciate my experience working with you undercover.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thanks, Julie.
You know, I never asked for anything from anybody, but I think it's amazing.
Okay, so how many of you felt the real felt emotion there? Okay, why?
She deserved a break.
She deserved a break.
Isn't that genuine?
It was genuine and authentic, wasn't it? So recognition, it has to be unexpected. It has to be for something real. And it has to feel like this person really does care. So I did some work for Innocent, the smoothie people.
Oh, yeah.
And somebody in the team had won a bottle of champagne for being the employee of the month. And she was quite vitriolic about it. She said, the bottle of champagne, I know they're just giving it to me because they've got to give it to somebody. It's not genuine.
Okay.
So, you know, when you've got the employee of the month or whatever it is, people are thinking, oh, you're just going through the motions of that because you know that you ought to. So this, it's unexpected, isn't it? So what do we know now about Julia? Probably.
Motivation
up, right?
She's
unlikely to. She's unlikely to quit next month, is she?
She'll give 100% and the rest.
Yeah. She'll give 100% and the rest. Now, I've got a lot of people who say that when they watch this, they go, "Yeah, that's all very well and good, but I haven't got 40,000 to give anybody." but what we have got are some other things, which don't cost. So you mentioned some of you the languages of love, which I think is Gary Chapman's work.
Mm.
I took that and I just thought about it and thought, what does that actually mean, though? In the corporate world, it's slightly different because there are different things that you can do. So the different things in the corporate world are symbols. You know, you get a little award from time to time, and you might have people just checking in, how you're doing. Thinking about you, it's Friday, I know you've had a rough week, you've been on for 6 days, just wondering how you're doing. That just sends an enormous amount of, it's not difficult to do, but it sends a huge message to people, doesn't it? Promotions is the obvious one. There's not so many of them around these days that I've noticed lurking in the corner. So I'd like you to think now, just in twos, when we generally got a favourite one, the one that we like the most. And what's interesting about when we give recognition to other people is we tend to give other people the one that we like the most. So it took me a bit of time to realise that time is number two. I don't give time really to people because I'm quite time short. But I had a member of my team who kept coming and sitting in my office and telling me what she'd done a lot of times. So I thought, okay, so what I'm getting here is she just needs half an hour of my time, not 5 minutes of my time. She needs half an hour of my time to tell me what she's done, for me to listen to all the details, for her to feel she's genuinely recognised by me. Now, I tend to bash out an email or send a text or a WhatsApp because I'm a wordy person, right? I write books. I'm a wordy person. Of course I'm a wordy person. So that's what I like. So, for example, I've got an email that someone sent me 10 years ago telling me that I'd made a difference to them. I've kept it. It's words. But other people like time. They like a gift and a treat. I was thinking of you. I saw this. And the acts of service. I know you're really busy. I'll do that interview for you. Touch. Hug. I've got a colleague who we call Huggy Russell. Because Huggy Russell needs about 7 hugs a day. He's not happy. Some people need the symbol of achievement, the thing on the wall that says I've done these things. Now I've got my degrees, I've got my qualifications. The checking in, the promotions I've mentioned. So I'd like you just to think about a time when you felt genuinely really recognised, and in pairs, or in a three, just talk about what that time was and which one of these it was for you. And by the way, money doesn't come into this because money is just a symbol. Right? So if you think about all those bankers who get those huge bonuses, it's a symbol for them. Right? The noughts are meaningless. If you started getting them fighting about Smarties, it would be exactly the same thing. Because it's a symbol of something else. It's a symbol of recognition. For them, they've forgotten what the numbers mean, unlike the rest of us. So there we go. Have a quick chat. And by the way, our data is very clear. It's not money. It's about something else, a value. So what's interesting in the room, and by the way, this is a really good thing to do with the team, just to find out what does everybody like, because then you know what floats their boat without having to guess. So you can sit and do this with a team very easily. It takes 15 minutes. You did it already. So we look like we're quite wordy, timey people, don't we, in this room? Wordy, timey people, and just the unexpectedness is a key factor in all of this. Okay. But it was really helpful for me when I did this with my team. Just thought, oh, okay, now I know what I need to give to whom. So that's a recognition. Why think about recognition? Because when you are recognised, what does it do? Builds capacity, right? You feel, oh, yes, I could do that again. Your motivation goes up. So it makes us feel we want to do more. And feeling good is fabuloso. Makes us feel resilient.